Spray-painted stars, sharp lines, and Stuff the Magic Dragon. On the wall of a brand new barbershop in Maitland, there's no better way to catch the eye of passing traffic.
This light's so busy at, you know, Horatio in 1792, so people are stuck looking at this, and if it gets them talking, gets them stopping, then it's good for the area.
Locals know these lights take nearly forever to change around Maitland City Center. Jonas Never isn't from the area, but he's learned quite a bit about Central Florida.
Just painting here, you get to know the areas, because, okay, you know, you go to different places for lunch already, you get to walk around, and it's also probably like, I don't know, the fifth or sixth, maybe seventh wall I've done in Central Florida, so trying to get a better feel for my way around.
A mural of Bob Ross in Winter Park, a Mr. Rogers painting at Rollins College, the LA-based mural artist saw an opportunity to bring the Orlando community together through sports.
The Magic's really the, you know, biggest sports team here, so kind of driving around, never saw any Magic murals, and the 90s players are kind of forever, and Stuff's been with the team forever, so it's a little more of a timeless quality.
Art and large-scale art has always piqued Jonas's interest, but he wanted his work to have meaning, especially when they're so hard to miss.
I started doing graffiti, got used to painting big and fast, and I realized that, like, it didn't really, at that point it wouldn't go anywhere, like the Banksy movie hadn't come out yet, street art wasn't a thing. So I was like, what can I paint that might actually have a lasting quality and appeal to the neighborhood instead of pissing off the neighborhood?
A lot of Jonas's most well-known murals are of sports figures, recently painting a Shohei Ohtani mural in LA after he signed with the Dodgers. Also LeBron, Kobe, and movies and shows. He knows the power an inspiring mural can have.
Sports is such a kind of rallying point for a community because everyone wears like the hats, the jerseys, it just pop culture, movies, or stuff that, like, you know, you certain areas can take pride in. This is probably arguably my favorite.
Jonas is a former college baseball player with UC Riverside.
I guess when you play sports, you get used to getting up early and like working all day on stuff. So it's kind of the same mentality with getting up here and painting. And I love that I get to paint stuff that I remember watching Penny and Shaq when I was a kid.
After 5 days working on this wall at Floyd's Barbershop with just him, Shaq, Penny, Little Penny, and Stuff, he saw it all come together, and now so will all of Orlando.
Very gratifying, but it's also scary because unlike most art, which you do in the privacy of a studio, you do this every step visible and everyone can see every step of the way, so you kind of got to do it right. Really haven't seen any Magic murals in the city, so for the first one to start with their two icons, I think it's a pretty great start, and hopefully some local artists will come and do Tracy McGrady or some other guys, keep it going.
141.
Every point, every win, is earned, not given. That's the way that Petey Bruce chooses to lead his life every single day.
Once you get in, you got in, you know? Oops.
They say pickleball is for everyone, and Petey is no exception. Born with no hands, one leg, he still finds a way.
Something told me to bring my strap, and I basically use this to hold the paddle. I played one day and got immediately hooked. There we go.
And when I say he finds a way, I mean he crushes it.
Yeah, take it easy,
I'm happy. Yeah, I'll try. But I love pickleball because of the fact that it gets my mind moving. It gets my thought process to really think over, okay, so I don't have hands, I've got short reach. That means I've got to move a lot. That means I have to find my angle, find my way of getting the right shot at the right time to get the point that I need. I think that's what we're all waiting for, is what's my shot? What's my, you know, what's my limitations? Where can I go in this world?
He's already come a long way across the world. Adopted when he was just 5 from the Philippines, his parents took in 10 children, all with their own limitations, but all of them told to never back down.
There are days when I cry. There are days when I get frustrated. There are days when I wish, you know, life wasn't so hard. But all of that, if I ever gave into that, that means I didn't learn a single thing from my parents.
Whether it was playing football with a semi-pro team, running a 5K, even playing the drums, and now pickleball.
It's just like with, you know, haters on the court, you gotta shut their mouth and kind of put it to the test.
It's why he stays on the advanced courts in Winter Park, to prove that he can play just like anybody else.
The initial reaction sometimes, if you've never played with me, is to go easy on it.
because I don't know if he can actually play. Until they start seeing me play, and they go, oh, he can serve like that. Oh, he can hit the ball and smash it like that.
And we always say it to each other whenever we play with against one another. No mercy. No one wants to play this game like that. Nobody wants to live life like that.
Petey took a leap of faith moving to Orlando a year ago with nothing but his faith and his steadfast belief in himself.
I like to tell a story, especially a true story and a good story at that. You know, you can come back and get a job because you have a job that could be, you know, available to you. Or you could stay and see how that story turns out. And that's what I'm here for, you know, and that's why I stayed, because I believe God still got a very big story to tell. And this is just one part of it.
Pickleball's begun this new chapter in Petey's life with a renewed sense of purpose and a community to inspire and be inspired by.
I'd like to think that me being here and me just loving this sport, you know, is something that people love to see in anybody, mm-hmm. You know, because it kind of helps them see it in themselves too.
Even a simple mantra can help you live your life for the moment.
It's what I say. If you have a passion of something, don't say, oh, maybe next year. No, life is too short. Start now.
It's a good day for a good day. Mona Rodriguez wears it proudly on her t-shirt, along with her heart on her sleeve every day. It's a simple reminder, sure, but it's been there for Mona throughout a time where she didn't know if there would be another good day.
I feel like I was about to die. I was gonna die, but I fight.
A fight for her life began this summer.
The only thing I can remember about that, July 11, I was coming here to do CrossFit, to work out. And I told one of the coaches, one of my good friends' story. I said, I will see you there. They never saw me.
What happened next all faded away.
No, just that I was going, that I was coming here. That's all I can remember.
She later learned that she was riding her motorcycle to the gym when a truck didn't see her while it was turning, hitting her from the left side. Next thing she knew, Mona was waking up in the hospital with a world of questions.
What am I doing in hospital? Why I have so many scars, so many surgeries, so many... My memory has no... nothing. I have no memory. I don't know who I was, what was my name, where I got born. I didn't know friends. I couldn't move. I couldn't talk.
The accident left Mona with brain bleeds affecting her memory, her mobility, left her broken physically, but her spirit never shattered.
It's big, it's super big. I didn't know how big it was, but this one broken, which is huge too.
Impossible for anyone to go through, but even harder for a professional athlete like Mona. She played for the Central Florida Crusaders indoor team this past season. The Columbia native came to America to play college soccer on a scholarship, then moved to Orlando to pursue the sport at the pro level. Soccer has always been her driver.
I think it's the time you put in that, like every practice. People's looking at you, you have motivation, kids. They feel like, oh, I cannot be like her, I wanna be like her.
4 months have now passed since the accident, and Mona's defying the odds each day.
Now I'm learning like a kid, you know? Because I'm super slow, I cannot do skills like I like to do. But you know, I couldn't even touch the ball before.
Relearning how to walk.
The nurses ask me, how you feel? I say, I feel alive.
And memories coming flooding back.
I was like, I can't believe that's me. Like, I was playing soccer, professional soccer. So I say, well, you know what? I need to go back soon.
She's working every day to getting back to play soccer and reminding herself that it's a good day for a good day.
I like to live my life the way I want to live, which is the day. Tomorrow I have other plans, but today is today.
This is on the house. This is on me, man.
Just a few days after NBA All-Star Weekend, Mac McClung is back to work.
I'm not doing too well.
It's your first day, bro. You're good.
Hey, I appreciate your patience. Thank you.
No, not that kind of work, though he did prove that he can dunk tenders in cane sauce almost as well as he can dunk a basketball.
I'm back-to-back slam dunk champion. Of course I dunk my chicken fingers in cane sauce.
It was back to the gym for Mac McClung. He defended his title as NBA dunk contest champ, including a perfect 50 score across the board when he dunked over Shaq. Something so unbelievable to think of, except for those who know Mac in his dreams.
Since I was young, I would always say I was going to do this and that, so they just kind of came numb to it, I think. And when I tell them things, it's like a week later, we'll look back at this and be like, man, Shaq was wearing my high school jersey. This is insane.
Mac says he's a dreamer with big ideas for himself, crafting show-stopping dunks where he says he would spend hours on FaceTime with his friends testing out new tricks to get their feedback. This all taps into the creative side of McClung.
I love directing films and writing poems. I think everything in life is art, so it's like basketball is an art form where it's nice to have an escape and have another art form that I like and I'm really passionate about. So it all intertwines together.
Over All-Star Weekend, Mac not only was part of the dunk contest and the Rising Stars game, but he still had time to tap into that creativity. He shared a music video to recap the weekend, put to the song Unwritten by Natasha Bedingfield.
That was our theme song throughout the week, and we kind of were making the video behind the scenes hoping that it worked out and we won. And I definitely say it relates to me in a lot of ways, and really just enjoying myself. You know, people want to like make you a victim or make you, you know, feel like something's not enough yet, but like I'm still going, I'm not going to quit, and I'm also enjoying the process as it goes.
The words, "the rest is still unwritten." Those tell the story of Mac's basketball journey, proving that he's more than just a dunk champion. He's also a star point guard in the G League, a top five scorer in it too, and he's looking for a chance in the NBA.
It's big for me, like, for everybody to understand. I'm having a great time now. I'm playing the game I love. I'm so hungry. I want to play against the best players in the world more than anything, but I'm not going to be happy once I get that. You know what I mean? I'm good now, and I'm going to keep chasing. Like, I'm not going to quit.
In Orlando, Danielle Stein, Spectrum Sports 360.